Hello everyone. So today we are going to see another interesting problem, shortest path in binary matrix. The input given is a two-dimensional integer array which consists of only zeros and ones, and we need to return the minimum path required to travel from the top left element to the bottom right element. So now here the zeros and ones are considered as empty and blocked. So we have to traverse only if the path is not blocked, which means you cannot hit one and travel through that path. You can pass through only zeros because zeros are empty and ones are blocked. So let's understand this problem with an example. So here is a given example. We are starting at the top leftmost element, that is zero. We are checking if this element is one, then the first cell itself is blocked. We cannot traverse through the matrix. So here itself our algorithm ends. If not, if it is a zero, then we have a chance of moving the element to all other directions. So now in this example, we can travel from zero to the next zero to the next zero and further proceed down all the way down to the last bottom rightmost cell zero. And the path here is starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we got one output, 5. So now here there is a condition that you can travel in all directions, that is even diagonally. So we just move to the second zero at here and we see there is one zero at the right. The one is at bottom, so we cannot travel via this path, and there is one more zero at diagonally present. So in this case, our second path is going to be starting from this zero to second zero and travel diagonally and then move to the down bottom rightmost cell. So now here the path goes from like one and diagonal step is 2 and 3 and 4, and we got 4 as another output. So here we need to check which is the minimum. 4 is the minimum effort or minimum path it took to travel from the topmost element to the bottom most element. So here 4 is our output. How are we going to approach this algorithm? If you remember, we have already solved a very similar problem in our channel, which is path with minimum effort. So whenever I see a word matrix, the first thing that hits me is BFS. So again, I'm going to solve this problem with using BFS only. As I said, we are going to solve this in BFS. The first thing we are going to have is our QQ comes for help always when it is BFS. So now our Q is going to hold an integer array of size 2, which is consisting of X and Y coordinates of each cell. That is, here the matrix can be represented in form of X and Y coordinate. That is, the first cell is going to be 0, 0 and the last cell is going to be 2, 2. So our Q is going to hold the positions of each element or each cell instead of the actual values. So now I'm going to put 0, 0. That is where we are going to start our traversing and check if that position is having value 0 or 1. If it is a 1, then it is not a valid case. The first cell itself is blocked and we cannot move further. So if it is a 0, then we are going to traverse and find all its neighbors. So what are the neighbors of a particular cell? That is the value present in all 8 directions. Why 8? Because we can traverse even diagonally. So now we are going to pull the element 0, 0 from the queue and populate all its neighbors and put it in the queue. So first, what are the neighbors of 0, 0? Neighbors of 0, 0 are 0, that is 0, 1, and 1, and this 1. We don't have previous cells because since it is the starting cell, so we have 3 neighbors. Out of this, we're going to check which of this is having 1. In this case, the 2 neighbors are having 1, so we can simply ignore because we cannot travel through that path. We can travel only if the value is 0. So the valid neighbor of 0, 0 is 0, 1. So now we are going to add 0, 1 in our queue. We don't have any other neighbors for this 0, so we are stopping with 0, 1. So now we are going to consider 0, 1 this position and traverse and find its neighbor. So here the neighbors of 0, 1 are 0, 2, 1, 1, and even we can travel diagonally. So 1, 2, and these as well are neighbors actually. But in this case, as we have moved from the first cell, we should not go back and traverse it again and again. It is going to be a duplicate work, or it will not come give us a solution. So in this case, if it is already visited, we are going to ignore this. We are going to ignore this cell. So how do we ignore this cell? In our previous method, while solving path with minimum effort, we will maintain another array visited or not to check whether this cell is already visited or not. But here, since it has only Boolean or binary values, that is zeros and ones, it is making our job very easy to identify the visited cells. That is, if the cell is already visited, I'm going to update the cell with value 1. In this case, whenever we see a 1, we will simply ignore that 1 and move ahead with zeros. So once we visit it, I'm just going to update the 1. So in this case, it will simply ignore that cell even if it has its value. So now we are going to populate the neighbors. So the neighbors of 0, 1 are going to be these 4 values. Out of these 4, we are going to ignore these 2 ones because we are not going to travel through ones. So the valid neighbors for 0, 1 is going to be 0, 2 and 1, 2. So I'm going to add these 2 to our queue. So now we have 2 neighbors of 0, 1, that is 0, 2 and 1, 2. Now it's time for us to populate its neighbors. So now first we are taking 0, 2. 0, 2 is here. So what are the possible neighbors for this? It can traverse diagonally or to the bottom. We don't have any other cells. As we have visited these 2 cells, I'm going to update it with 1. So it is simply going to ignore these ones and these one as well. So the valid neighbor for 0, 2 is going to be 1, 2 alone. So I'm going to update my queue with 1, 2. So now as we have traversed 0, 2, I've updated 0, 2 with 1. And we have its neighbor 1, 2 as well as 1, 2 is entering the queue. So now as we move through this, I'm going to update another variable result. Every time we move a step ahead, I'm going to count or increment the result variable. So far, our result is going to be 3. So now we are going to explore the neighbors of 1, 2. So our 1, 2 is here. Its possible neighbors are, it can traverse diagonally or left or bottom. So we simply, as usual, ignore these ones. And we have only one possible neighbor, that is the bottom cell 2, 2. So I'm going to add 2, 2 to my queue. So we are done with this 1, 2. If you go to 1, 2 again, it will be traversed already because we have updated that with 1. Whenever it sees it 1, which means the way is blocked and it will terminate. So this also will be popped out of queue. So finally, we have only 2, 2. Now we are going to traverse 2, 2, so we are popping that from our queue. Once we pop, we are going to update our result plus 1, that is 4. We reached the 4th level. So now 2, 2 is our last cell. This is where our matrix ends. That is 2, 2 is actually the length, row and column of the given matrix or size of the given matrix. So in this case, as we have reached our destination, this is where we have to return our result. So 4 is going to be the result for this problem. So let's see how are we going to code it. So now first I'm getting the rows and columns of the given grid. Here M and N represent row and column of the given two-dimensional array. So we are going to check basic conditions that if the first cell of grid itself is 1, in that case itself is 1, or the last cell is going to be 1, in this case it is an invalid grid. We cannot travel from top to bottom. So return -1. The second condition is, if the matrix itself is 1x1 matrix, then there will be only one solution to travel. We are checking whether n minus 1 is equal to 1, and then m minus 1 is equal to 1, and the first value is 0, 0. Sorry, the first value is going to 0, then the solution is going to be 1. So basic conditions are done. So I have declared an integer array, two-dimensional array directions. It is having coordinates where I'll add each coordinate to point at the 8 different directions to represent its neighbors. So that is done. So I'm going to declare one more variable, result. And finally, I'm going to declare our Q here. Q. So now our Q is going to have our first coordinate. So we are adding our Q with So we have added our first cell to our Q. So now we are going to poll each value from Q, and we are going to populate its neighbor and add it to the Q. So for that, I'm going to have my while loop, considering if my queue is not empty. So how many elements are there in the queue, we are going to poll them. So I'm just taking the size of the queue. So once I take the size of the queue, I'm going to have a for loop. So now we are going to save the values or poll the values from Q. So until the size is going to be empty, that is, we're going to poll the how many ever values are there in the queue, we are going to poll that. So once we poll the value, we are going to populate all its neighbors. So possible neighbors can be in 8 directions. That is, we can travel 4 directions and then diagonally 4 directions. So we are simply, as we know, it is going to take 8 entries. I am going to declare a variable and iterate it till size 8. So I'm going to calculate my coordinates, that is, new x is going to be, and my new y is going to be array of 1 plus. The second value from directions. So once our neighbors are calculated, we are going to check if it is a 1 or 0. If it is a 1, we are not going to add it to the queue or simply ignore it. So now I have checked whether the new x is less than 0 or greater than n, that is, if it is before the index of matrix or after, extend beyond the size of the matrix, or the value is 1, we are going to simply ignore, which means if at all it is holding the value 0, then we are going to travel through that path. Also, I'm gonna check if at all we reached the destination, that is the bottommost cell, then we are going to return the result. So in this case, if my, that is, the new coordinate is equal to m minus 1 and new y is going to be n minus 1. In this case, we have reached a destination. So simply we are going to return result plus 1. Why 1? Because that is our destination. We reached one more level. So finally, as I said, I'm gonna assign the values to grid we visited to 1 so that we don't have to retraverse it. If at all it crossed all the conditions, that is, it is not 1, it is not beyond size, and it is not the destination, then it must be a 0. In that case, add it to our queue. As we have done adding all our neighbors, we are going to increment our result for every level. And so if we have reached a destination within the loop itself, it will return the result. If not, it is not returning the result. In this case, it will be an invalid matrix. So we are going to return minus 1 at the end. Now let's run. Submit. You can find the code in my description. And this actually runs in big O of M and where, as usual, M and N are going to be the size of the matrix. So thanks for watching. Thank you.